Wine, and by extension Proton, are incredibly important tools on Linux, and you might not personally use them, but as I've said before, if I could not game on my Linux system, I probably wouldn't have started daily driving Linux. And I'm not the only one. There are a lot of people out there where gaming is an incredibly important use case. They like gaming. They're not going to stop gaming. You can say, oh, gaming's a waste of time, all that stuff you want to say. But if people want to do it, they're going to use the system that lets them game. And ever since people have grown interested in using Linux because of the Steam Deck, ever since they've seen that Linux gaming is not only possible, but viable, and in many cases, actually good, unless you want to play some of those heavy anti-cheat games where developers don't want to go and enable support, but that's a separate thing. Also along with this, we are moving from a state where everything is done on the traditional X11 over to Wayland. Now I say moving, but it's more like we've already moved, most people have accepted it, and then there are still some stragglers that are kind of left behind. And whilst X Wayland isn't going to go anywhere anytime soon, it might one day, I don't know, we don't know what the future's going to hold. It would be nice to be able to run a full Wayland desktop and not actually need X Wayland, and only use X Wayland in the case of running legacy software which never is going to be ported over to Wayland. And I'd say for the most part, this is exactly what you can do. If you go to X Wayland, you probably wouldn't notice it. Unless you're using an app based on an older version of Electron, Chromium is still a little bit experimental with Wayland support, but if you're using Firefox, its Wayland support is fine, it's enabled by default, no issue whatsoever. And then obviously the random little apps that either haven't been ported or are abandoned and never going to be updated anyway. And of course, things running inside of Wine. Wine applications, whether that be an application like Paint or a game like Marvel Rivals, that was going to run through X Wayland on Wayland. And finally, at last, for some, that day has come to an end. Just a few days back, we saw the release of Wine 10. And amongst various other changes, like you'd expect in a normal Wine update, along with improvements to the Wayland driver has now been enabled by default. But a lot of titles and a lot of people are only reading this part. This is important because this means the driver is going to be enabled inside of the main build of Wine. You won't need to go and compile it yourself or download some weird package which somebody else has made for a build or add any custom patches, nothing like that. It'll be enabled by default. But make sure you actually read the rest of what is being said. But the X11 driver still takes precedence if both are available. To force using the Wayland driver in that case, make sure the display environment variable is unset. So, if you are running on an X11 desktop, you're running Awesome WM, you're running KDE under Xorg, that is going to use the X11 driver. If you're running KDE on Wayland, Hypeland on Wayland, and you have X Wayland enabled, this is going to use the X11 driver. The only time right now it is going to use the Wayland driver is if X Wayland is not available or has been disabled in some other way. So you literally don't install X Wayland, or you go out of your way to unset this environment variable. And the reason why it's like this is simple. It's ready enough where having it enabled isn't going to break anything. The code builds correctly. It works well enough where they're willing to let the regular user go and test it if they know what they're doing. But it's not ready enough that they want it to be the option that users first see when using Wine under Wayland. It has enough regressions, enough missing features where you should still have to opt into using it, but you shouldn't have to go and build Wine yourself just to get access to it. It should be slightly out of the way where you're not going to accidentally do it, but easy enough where they can get more people testing it. Even without taking the open issues into account, just looking at the things that actually have patches available, the open merge request, you can already start to see a couple of things where it probably should be addressed before it's enabled by default. One of those is implement support for the XDG top level icon protocol. This is a Wayland protocol that allows different windows of the same application to make use of different window icons. Previously, what would happen is all of the windows of the application would use whatever icon is supplied by the desktop file. But let's say for some reason you have your main application and then... Actually, let's go with GIMP. Let's say you have GIMP, the main application has the GIMP icon, and then you want to have it so the tool popout has a tool icon. You want to have it so the color popout has a color icon. The settings has a settings icon. That is something you couldn't do before. That's what this protocol lets you do, and that's what you can do on Windows perfectly fine. So having support for that as well makes sense. Not having it there is a bit of a regression. Is it a big deal? Is it going to break some applications? It'd be slightly annoying, but it doesn't really matter that much. Or we have support shaped and transparent windows. There aren't that many windows that aren't just going to be a rectangle or a square, which is a form of rectangle. But there are some. Let's say you're using some weird old media player which has... just weird shapes. Some of them are circles, some of them just do weird other random things, and you kind of need that support there. More recently though, there's an application like Marvel Rivals, which on Linux now you have to go and enable the Steam Deck mode so the launcher isn't actually shown. Previously though, the launcher looked like this, which is exactly the kind of thing that this would help fix. Or we have this. Fix Alt tabbing out, another thing which you probably want to work just fine. Now, for any of you weebs out there who are curious how this might have been discovered, well, it's found because of Toho 6 Embodiment of Scarlet Devil. The only Toho game I've played. I'm not good at it. I'm actually horrible at it. But it's just a fun little fact. Now keep in mind, these aren't the issues that have been reported. These are issues that have patches available to deal with them already. There is for sure, guaranteed, 100% going to be additional issues that have not yet been discovered, that have not yet been patched. Whether it's going to be some weird hardware configuration, some weird software that does some just random esoteric thing. Maybe some applications used to do it, but it's not really that popular now, so it's not really something that was really being accounted for. Maybe it's a missing Wayland protocol that is still being worked on, and at some point is gonna have to be addressed in the driver as well, but right now, it kind of leads to a regression. And there's for sure going to be problems that are discovered by more people using it, by making it easier for the driver to be used, not just by developers and interested third parties, but by people running a regular, clean build of wine, mostly clean build, some distros do apply patches, but mostly clean build of wine that they get from their distro, whether it's an Ubuntu or an Arch or a Gentoo or Fedora, having it be in the default build, very nice. Now, I'm watching you. Before you go and install Wine 10 on the distro that has a package available, probably something like Arch right now, Ubuntu and that, you know, they're going to take a while to get it. Before you go and disable the display environment variable, or just don't install X-Wayland and then complain, oh, why is this not working when I try to run a game in Steam? There's a very, very important caveat when it comes to Proton. Whilst Proton is based on Wine, Proton itself is not Wine. Proton tends to lag a couple of versions behind whatever the Wine project is doing. So Valve is also going to want to do some of their own internal testing, make sure this works well, and do all that stuff. There's no guarantee they're going to keep it enabled inside of Proton. I don't really see any reason why they would get rid of it because it's basically just being used as a fallback. And I don't really see why they would change the ordering as well. So it's not like it's going to be at the top of the precedence list if it's not at the top in Wine. So it'll probably still be enabled in Proton in the same way it's being enabled in regular Wine. But Proton's just not going to have it yet because it's not the right version. It's lagging behind a bit. So I would expect probably sometime in the next month, maybe 2 months, for Proton 10 to come out, for a version of this to have the driver enabled by default, and then it'll be very easy to go and test. But if we're just talking about regular old Wine, in that case, yes, it is going to be really easy to go and test. Go and disable the display environment variable, uninstall the XWLAN package if that's the way you want to do it, but clearing variables is going to be a lot easier. Test it out, see how it works. If there are any bugs, go and report the bugs. And if there are any bugs with specific software, that's also very useful as well. So make sure you include any information that you know is relevant to doing the bug report. I know not everybody's interested in doing so, but there is quite a few people interested in a full Wayland desktop. Not because it's necessarily so much better to go from a 99% Wayland where pretty much everything you run, your desktop, most of your applications, and then just like one or two little things that are running under xWayland, but because it's just cool. It's cool to be able to say, I don't need xWayland on this system. I have a system where if xWayland ever stops being packaged, ever stops being updated, I just don't need it. And future systems don't necessarily need to have xWayland available, but it's just there as like a nicety where, yeah, you might want to go and run it for some legacy application, but you don't need it. You can have a system that is fully Wayland, like you can have a system that is fully X11. Now, if you're curious about some of the history of this driver, I did do a prior video about exactly that, prior to the driver being merged. So be sure to go and check that one out because, you know, I think that was kind of a fun video. I didn't realize I was closing the curtain that recently. I don't know. Let me know how you feel about like the curtain being open or closed. It's kind of a thing I'm trying out. I don't really know what I prefer. I don't know. It's a different look. Trying things out. It's a new year, you know, try things out and see how it goes. Anyway, let me know your thoughts down below. If you have tried out Wine Wayland, let me know. That would be cool. And if you're excited for a fully Wayland system, I'd love to know as well. So if you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, LiberaPay, linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I need some wine. I don't like wine, but like, I'll drink it anyway. Like this.